Mods, Madu, we are the children, we are the children of God. Come, 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 we change our world, we have what it takes to do it smart and make it smart. Welcome to our Smart Do.
Welcome to Us Fives once again for a lesson. And I hope you are really doing on and going on well. Now, today, we're going to look at the subunit True Happiness. Now, I'm sure there are many moments whereby you have ever been happy. You have ever been happy. Now, when we talk about being happy, is when you find that you are enjoying because of something. You are not sad. And many moments we ever found ourselves happy. For example, during yes, good birthdays. When you are celebrating birthdays, we are usually very happy because we know there is a lot of cake, there is a lot of juice to eat, there is a lot of there are a lot of biscuits that you are going to eat, and also maybe you are going to receive a lot of presents. So we are always very happy when you are celebrating birthdays. Another time that you are happy, yes, during weddings, as somebody has said, during weddings, yeah, during a wedding, you realize that maybe you're going to get a new suit, a new dress, a new pair of shoes, and you're going to, at the wedding, we're going to celebrate, you eat the cake, you eat the food, maybe you are one of those who will be accompanying the bride or the bridegroom in the wedding. So we are very happy. Another time we are happy, yes, during celebrations, celebrations, such as, yes, somebody has said Christmas Day, yeah, such as Christmas Day, or when you have national holidays like Mashujaa Day, we find that we are always happy because of the things that are going around. Now, here in this case, we are not talking about happiness in relation to these events. But you're talking about happiness that comes from Jesus Christ. Happiness that comes from Jesus Christ. Now, how do you get this happiness? How do you get this happiness? Now, this happiness from Jesus Christ is God when you believe in Him. When you believe in Him, you believe in Him. And you believe that He came from heaven to die for our sins. Once you believe in Him and believe that He died for our sins, that is the greatest joy of a believer or a Christian. Why? Jesus died for our sins so that we can be forgiven. We are forgiven. I'm sure even when you do something wrong at home and you are forgiven, or you do something wrong in class and you are forgiven, you feel very happy. Now, imagine that Jesus Christ died for our sins and now we are forgiven. And once you are forgiven, there is that chance, there is that hope of receiving eternal life. So, this is the true happiness that you are talking about. The joy, the hope of receiving eternal life. Eternal life, and say it is, eternal life, you say this, yes, it is life without an end. So, this is where our true happiness comes from. Now, as a Christian, it is important to follow the teachings of Christ so that we can be happy, so that we can live the true happiness that Jesus talks about. So how do we get this happiness? Now, one way I've already mentioned, other ways that you get true happiness, one of them is already there, yes, following God's commands. When we follow God's commands, God is very happy with us and He's going to bless us, and we are assured of true happiness whenever we Do as he wants. Another way we attain true happiness. Yes. Somebody has said, assisting the less fortunate. Assisting the less fortunate in the community. Once we assist them, there is that joy that comes in you helping somebody at one time or the other, even maybe in class or at home or at the market. You assisted somebody maybe carry a heavy load. And once you realize that they are happy, you are also very happy that you are able to help them do or carry the heavy load or do some activity. Another way that you can receive true happiness. Yes. Preaching the word of God. Preaching the word of God to those who are not able or have not yet received the word of God. So once we preach to them and they realize that God is good and they receive and accept it, that will bring true happiness in our lives. Another one maybe that you can have. Yes. Visiting the sick in hospital. Yes. Visiting the sick in hospital. You can also visit orphans. You can also visit orphans whereby you go and have some activities with them. Another way, visiting prisoners. You can visit prisoners. Yes, prisoners. They are also people and they need to learn about God so that they can also share in true happiness, the true happiness that God has guaranteed us. Now, in the Bible, we have in the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 4 to 5. There we find what the Bible tells us, what is true happiness. Now, and according to the Bible, the true happiness is also called the Sermon of the Mount. The Sermon of the Mount. And let's see, what does the Bible tell us about true happiness? Matthew chapter 5, verse 4 to 5. Now, it says, happy are those, that is verse 4, happy are those who mourn, God will comfort them. Happy are those who mourn, God will comfort them. Happy are those who mourn, God will comfort them. Now, we know why people mourn. Mourning is a sad moment. We mourn because somebody has died. We mourn because somebody has died. And once we find somebody mourning, what do? We comfort them. We try to make them feel better by telling them that is not the end of life. So, happy are those who mourn. God will comfort them. Verse 5 says, happy are those who are humble. Happy are those who are humble. They will receive what God has promised. Happy are those who are humble. Happy are those who are humble. They will receive what God has promised. They will receive what God has promised. And what has God promised? God has promised that eternal life without an end. So if we are humble, and humble people do as they are asked. They do as they are asked or told. So once you are humble, you will receive. I'm sure even at home, when you are a humble person, you receive many presents from your parents. So imagine God, what he will do to you when you are humble. He will give you what he has promised. And what he has promised is eternal life. He has promised eternal life. Therefore, let us try and find true happiness in God Though you also find happiness in the things of the world, but the true happiness comes in believing in Jesus Christ so that we can receive eternal life as it has been promised. So keep on reading the scriptures, keep on following God so that you can receive true happiness from Him. Otherwise, have a good time. We're going to meet during the next lesson. Bye-bye.